our kitchen table. And we can see it just starts off with actually a boat trailer hub, of course the shaft. And the top is just a piece of a coal road, big enough to handle the biggest saw that we've got. You'll notice on top we've got these holes drilled with the bolts set through. There's an Allen head bolt coming through from the bottom with a lock nut. We set these with a dial indicator. And we set the thickness for the saws that we have the most of, which is actually our 090 plate 19-inch DVJ saws. And then for the other saws that we use, we just have some shim stock that we lay across the top of these bolts to compensate for the difference in the width and teeth. And then up here, we have the air cylinder with the plate that holds the saws down. A little air valve, we'll watch it come down. If this don't have any pressure, it's just a weight. The weight, it comes down and sets on top of the saw. Of course, you'll notice a couple of plates here. This is for a different size saw. We just take these loose and then slide this one out, and then this plate can come over a smaller saw. We try to keep the plate fairly close to the saw tips. And this rod, it don't push down, it's loose, it extends through, and there's no safety factor there, no harm whatsoever for getting your fingers underneath it. It all works slow and slow control valve. Now here's, I've got some shims set up these edger saws that Jesse's fixing to set on there. I'll show you how we do them for a different thickness saw. It just centers it up on the table, and then we'll let the top plate come down. This is a thick saw, so we don't worry as much about the hold down plate getting that close to the teeth. And then we'll just tip them like that. This is Jesse. We're going to let him just tip the saw. These are the ones that we have the most of by far. The Phoenix Curve Saw Chainsaw. We have a lot of vibration up here. If you ever go to work, you just have a little bit to get used to it. We need to just keep tips laying up in there. A little bowl like picture on top of it. Real handy. He's just laying in all the tips. 34 tips all around right now. Turns the table with his feet. It don't take no time at all to get used to doing that. found out with this plate on top, everything laying flat, that we don't hardly have any problem with the heat. Just start the tension that's in the saw. After we tip it, we'll let it lay there until it cools down. That plate absorbs just virtually all the heat from those teeth, and then it does not add tension to the saw with the tipping process. See, it's pretty fast operation. Tip is not a big, long, time-consuming job with us. We can knock out a half a dozen saws a day. Generally, what we tip is just a very few minutes. With the adjusted bolt sticking to the plate, the exact clearance has already been set, and We don't have any problems. If you have any problems, just because you don't have the saw level. We try not to do that. We try to have them level before they come over here. We run a 140 curve, and we use a 160 tip. So we have about 10 thousandths on each side of the saw that we play with on the ground.